What's good? It's your boy Lamont with another video, as you guys can see from the title and the thumbnail. Today I am bringing you guys the best guard build. It can be an ISO build if you want an ISO. You can set screens with this build. It's the all-around build. You can pretty much do everything. And we finally on next gen. Y'all was saying next gen. I know y'all just got the game today, so it's perfect that I release my next gen build. Now listen, I'm gonna have more than one build. I don't know what's gonna be my solidified 100% build yet, because this builder, you can get so creative. It's so many options. Like, this is a complex builder. It's not what you guys think. Like, it's nothing like, this builder is nothing like 2K21 next gen at all. So we finna have fun with this, but I'm giving y'all that universal build that you can use. So as you guys can see with this build, I'm going 6'3", 170 pounds, and my wingspan is 6'3". Built, y'all can choose whatever y'all want. Now, I'm gonna explain all the reasons. On the right side of the build, you can see the possible choices. I'll be able to contact dunk with this build. On this game, if you just want pro contacts, I think you only need like an 84. All you need is the 84 driving dunk on this game for pro. Elite is 92, which is OD. So we don't need elite, you feel me? But you wanna be able to finish and go to the rack, because defense is good on this game. So not only will I be contact dunking, I'm gonna be, look at my shooting, bro. Look at my possibilities for my shooting ratings, bro. That is insane. And then look at my ball handling. Like I told y'all, I could do everything with ball handling. Now, if I had the points for defense, y'all see my options. I could get a 93 steal if I want that. But listen, this build will be the build I use for events. Build I use for comp stage. Like, this is a 3v3 build, 3v3. So whereas though, you know, you get a comp lineup. Y'all gotta start learning how to get comp lineups where you play with a lockdown, you play with your paint beast, or you play with your, you know, like your popper build. So y'all gotta learn that, bro. Like, that's how you jump into the comp scene. Then as you guys can see, I'm gonna be super speedy Gonzalez, super fast, bro. As you guys could see. But now let me go into the complexity and show you guys the finesses. So all of my badge points are already here, and like I said, I'm gonna show you why I have certain things for certain reasons. So starting with driving layups, and by the way, with this setup, you can see the badges that you guys want. So with my driving dunk, well no, I said driving layup. So driving layup is a 70, just so that I can choose certain layup packages. You need at least 70 to get like certain layup packages. Of course, y'all gonna want like long athlete, stuff like that. So that's why I got that. My driving dunk is an 84, just so I have the ability to dunk on people. Like, I'm not trying to dunk on people OD. Like, that's not my primary thing, but I want to be able to finish. Look, I can get unstrippable, I can get slithery, and then I can get posterizer on silver. Now look, for people who like, what about posterizer on Hall of Fame? Boy, do you see what it requires? For Hall of Fame posterizer, you need a 99 driving dunk. That is OD. So it's like, on this game, you gotta make sacrifices, yo. You're not gonna be able to try to like OD demigod 99 on every single category. Like, no, they got that out of there, bro. They got that out of there. And a power forward, they got that out of there too. So I'm gonna show y'all the badges I chose after the fact, but I'm just showing y'all the little joint. You could press triangle to extend the category. So that's the reason for this category. Second category, my mid-range. My mid-range shot is a 97. It's only 97 because, as you can see, I can get Green Machine Hall of Fame. That's just what I wanted to have. I can get Hot Zone Hunter Hall of Fame. You gotta have it over 96, 97 to do this. Y'all don't have to do this. Y'all can edit y'all mid-range if y'all don't want those badges Hall of Fame, but that's what I wanted, Hall of Fame. Now my three-point shot is a 93 specifically for this badge. This is the new range extender, the new deep threes, whatever you want to call it. This is that badge, so I wanted it on 93. Now when you over 86, you can get lucky number 7. You can get mismatch expert. I think this is gonna be fire. Like, imagine somebody who set screens, and when the big get on you, now you get a boost for having to plan against a mismatch. Like, that's a W, bro. Everything gonna be a mismatch for my build because it's 6'3". And then oh yeah, you need, look, you need a 94 midi and a 94 three-point shot to get this badge Hall of Fame, bro. So, and on this gen, if y'all not noticing, which I'm gonna get into, badges cost like different numbers now. It's not just only four no more for Hall of Fame, if that makes sense. So those are my reasons for that category. Now look, my build name, I'm gonna end up I could change the MIDI just to get a different build name, but we gonna see. But anyway, pass accuracy. At least make your pass accuracy, like y'all, this is y'all debate. Y'all can do this. I only need a 70 for me and my teammates. This is the most easiest shooting game in 2K history. Next gen and current gen. This 2K22 is the easiest shooting game ever. So I don't have to have Hall of Fame dimer for my teammates, bro. Like, I just don't have to have that. So therefore, I'm only giving them bronze dimer on this build. At least I'm getting silver bullet passers. So, but you feel me? Like, if shooting was more difficult, I would try to get it. But look what you need, though, bro. You need a 97 pass accuracy to get that. So, like, that's unnecessarily OD. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty. My ball handling, as you guys can see, is a 93. So, I can get stuff like this. Look, you need 91 for handles for days. So, wow, you know, that's how you don't get tired. So, you got to have that. The new badge, Hyperdrive. It says, increases the speed at which a player can perform moving dribbles as they attack down the court. Like, who don't want that on the threes court? I can get glue hands, which is nothing too crazy, but you only need a 74 for that. Quick chain, another OP playmaking badge. I needed at least a 92 on my ball handling. So, I got that out the way. Like, I hit all the requirements. Look, my speed with ball is at 92 on that dot, so I can get Hall of Fame quick first step. Like, this is going to be my build. I'm going to be so fast, bro. Already see it now. Y'all will get the gameplay in my next video for next gen in this build, but I move so fast, bro, with this build. Like, it's funny. Now, in the defensive category, like I told y'all, this is not a defensive build. I'm strictly playing threes with this build, event build. So I got lockdowns and other people to guard ball and stuff like that. However, when you watch the video, I'm still guarding people with no defense because defense is just so OP this year. So just throwing it out there, but that's not my focus with this build. And then when we come down to the physicals, I sacrifice my speed down to a 90 because I'm still fast, my acceleration to a 90, and then my stamina 99. But when you go to the Gatorade, you can still get +4 on these categories. So I have a 94 speed and a 94 acceleration, which is cool. Like I said, those sacrifices was because I wanted certain badges Hall of Fame. I'm telling y'all, and y'all know this if you got the game. When you're making your build, you can't get everything, and y'all be like it's certain places you gotta find the sacrifices, bro. Like, the one moment you put 1 point on something, we won't be able to get something else. So for me, this is a W, just overpowered. Like, I don't know, like, this is the best all-around guard build that I like, as far as like doing everything offensively. Like, I still can dunk, still can shoot, I get all the dribble moves, I can like, it's perfect, bro. Like, it's too perfect, and I'm still fast. So this is that all-around build that y'all gonna see a lot. And like I said, if you care about names, you can adjust stuff. But we about to see what name that I get. Now, we got this category. I chose limitless range and ankle breaking shots because that's what I want to do. Yes, my build is complete. And then, as you guys can see, they are calling me a shot creator. The reason why I got the name shot creator is because my mid range is the highest attribute. It's a whole 97. So you know, a shot creator basically is finesse in the mid-range area. So that's what they call this build. W, I like it. This is gonna be my first next gen build. Well, of course we're gonna have a bunch of other next gen builds, but now let me do the build tester for you guys. All right, so let me go ahead and put the badges on for you guys, what I would choose. Let me see if it's already selected for me. All right, so I gotta select it from scratch again. That's a W. So look, now y'all can see how I divvy up the cost. So I would get posterizer silver, slithery finisher gold. Y'all see how gold requires 5 now? Crazy, right? Now, this badge, I would have to test this. I don't know how OP limitless takeoff is yet, but it could be OP. So I don't know whether to get this. I might go just silver for now or bronze to test it, but it's something we have to test. Now, I do want unstrippable gold because I don't want to get ripped when I'm going for it. You feel me? I have the opportunity to still get giant slayer, and I could get pro touch. Oh, can I get a silver? Oh, I can't. Okay. So what else? What am I missing? Oh, acrobat. So this is my finishing setup. Shooting. Oh, it's so much shooting. You got to go with blinders. I might or might not get dead eye because blinders is like dead eye. Look, it's a jump shot taken with a defender closing out. And then this one, if it's like closing out, we receive less of a penalty from the shot contest. We might do both. First, let me see what else I want. I want Green Machine Hall of Fame. I would get lucky number 7 if my 3 ball was low, but I probably don't need it. I'm not sure how OP set shooter is yet, Because it say give a boost shooting rating for somebody standing still. So that might be the real spot up joint, but it might still can work. I don't know, bro. Stop and pop. Boost shot rating on standstill threes after dribbling. That sound fire, bro. But hold on. Let me look around first because I got to get my main badges. I want mismatch expert. Low key, I might not get mismatch expert, though. It's a lot to debate with this, yo. That's what make this game fun. Hall of Fame. Hall of Fame. Don't need sniper. Sniper, I think it's going to be a fire badge, but me personally, I don't need sniper. So what I got left? 10 points left. I need to test this badge. Boost my shot rating on a standstill three after I dribble. It's just like my rating is so high. I'll go dead eye. Because my rating is so high, I don't need boost to my three. You feel me? Like, I don't need boost. Like, right now, I could end it off with clutch shooter if I wanted to. I can get this mismatch thing and get both. Let me see. That requires three. So I can go. Yeah, because none of the other ones intrigue me. So I'm cool on that. So I'll go clutch shooter silver because it ain't that deep. But then I'll go mismatch expert on gold. Fire setup, bro. Fire setup. Playmaking, the beautiful. Ankle breaker, bullet passer off rip. Diamond for my teammates. Bailout. We going to do quick chain and hyperdrive gold. And it's a reason. Y'all about to go crazy when I tell you this next stuff. Hall of Fame quick first step. Handles for days Hall of Fame, of course. And all that. That's pretty much all we need. Oh, yeah. I probably need this, though. Unpluckable. Hold on. What could I change? I need unpluckable. How can I finesse unpluckable on here? Let me take hyperdrive off for a second and just get bronze on this. I got three left. I can go silver. All right, this is what I wanted to tell y'all. Look, listen. Oh, yeah, I can make this bronze for now and then do that. All right, I'll do this. Oh, I got one more badge point? Hold on. This required three. I got one more. Where could one more go at real quick? I can get a space creator bronze. Can I upgrade this? Yes, I can make unpluckable silver. That's a W. All right, what I was going to tell y'all is once you play in college, you complete college, you get boost. Hold on. Actually, let me put it on the screen. I want y'all. All right, I want y'all to see this real quick, bruh. So college, you have option to do college, G League, and all of that, and you get different boosts. So when you complete college and do the championship, as you can see, all these colleges give you some extra attribute points. So for me, I'm going to choose Syracuse so that I can get three more playmaking points, and that's going to allow me to, like, that's going to be insane because these can go Hall of Fame now if I wanted to, if I need bullet pass or higher. So I'm going to get three more extra playmaking, and I'm going to get one more shooting badge if I complete Syracuse. But you guys could choose the one that you want. That's the one I'm going to choose. But that's pretty much it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this banger, man. Hey, in the comment section, what are we playing, bro? Like, I literally want y'all to type one word in the comment section for the game that you are playing. So everybody watching this video, literally type current gen or type next gen in the comment section. I want to know. Or somebody can type both because I like both, me personally, bro. Make sure you guys hit that like button for your boy. Make sure you subscribe and have them post notifications on because we are uploading every single day. And we out of here. Yeah.